Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Yeah, this is our first card of the year, I think. I still have that middle one as well, but that's going to go out after this. Pretty sure now. So, review of Eve of the Daleks coming after this shortly. But first of all, we just wanted to address the
sea devil in the room.
Well, exactly. You know, it's like one of those things, like with other episodes, I've had this, like, as good as an episode as Village of the Angels was for me, the abiding memory of that was the Next Time Trail with Kate Stewart. And it's a similar sort of thing here where
I know what you mean.
That
actually,
is like
the
one thing that sticks with you.
It's weird how much it overrides. Like, yeah. I finished the episode going, that was quite nice. And, no way. So literally, I was just permanently thinking sea devil, word sea devil for an hour. Mm-hmm. I think I messaged you, because I messaged you midway through the episode saying, Thasmin.
Yeah.
I also said at the very end, sea devil. All caps.
Yeah.
And I literally, it came on the screen, a legend of the, how Chibs knew exactly what he was doing. He knew he had us on the edge of our seats. And as that sea devil came to the camera, I literally just screamed at my television, no!
I literally, when I first saw it, the trailer, for a split second I did think, is the Easter special called Legend? Because that was the first word. And it was of the sea devil.
Very clever how similar to Invasion of the Dinosaurs began as Invasion, and then subsequent episodes, Invasion of the Dinosaur.
Yeah.
How
very nice,
amazing. Yeah. Now, I was thinking this. Mm-hmm. Is this the first villain, returning surprise that we've had since when? When is the last time that it's appeared on screen and that's been the first time we've known about it? Maybe Alpha Centauri in Empress of Mars. But
I'm trying to think of other examples now. I mean, in terms of...
Because they've always promoted... promoted as the big, oh my god, these are returning.
In terms of other ones we've had recently, I mean, there really haven't been that many where it's been directly returning for the first time from the classic era. Mm. Like, we've had the Mondasian Cybermen, if you want to count that.
Again, they were leaked slash.
Exactly, that was the revealed, wasn't it? Yeah. We had the before that, I think, was the Zygons and the Ice Warriors and the Great Intelligence.
Again, Zygons leaks.
But we knew about. I think the Great Intelligence, we sort of knew, but then again, it's not a monster, is it?
Yeah, because it's not like the Yeti popping up, was it?
It was like a random thing where it was like GI, and it's
It's a very different thing to have a redesigned classic monster appear on screen and not even have any inkling about it. Like, maybe there was rumblings that, it's a pirate episode, it's in the sea, there might be sea devils. And we've had that, I think, since Series 8 or something like that.
Yeah,
and it's we are never going to get a sea devil episode. They're not going to do it. Because why are they going to bother doing it? And it sort of feels like, are we actually getting Jodie Whittaker's penultimate episode called Legend of the Sea Devils? It's actually insane.
It is.
Bonkers. I mean, what do we think of the look of the fight?
Yeah, I've got a pair of me. I'm just out of shot.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous.
It's just everything you'd want it to be.
Compare that to the Silurian redesign, and I mean, I'm not saying that was bad. But
I know what you mean.
How much they've recreated the original design, and yet given it that modern lift. It's animatronic, or at least they've made the face move.
Yeah, whatever it is.
Because in that trailer, I kept rewatching that shot again and again and again.
Yeah.
And as it walks towards the camera, the mouth sort of makes a sort of movement, the eyes are blinking.
Yeah.
It's insane. One of the best classic redesigns, if you can call it that, revamps, I suppose, is the better word.
Yeah, because it literally is a direct sort of upgrade to the original.
Yeah, it's an upgrade, really. Upgrade. Yeah, yeah. It's not back to the drawing board. It's let's take this thing and I think that in this world of I know you're not a Star Wars fan, but you watch series like Book of Boba Fett that's just come out or Mandalorian, and they brought back the original kind of masks from the 70s and the 80s that they used in the films. And yet, just given that them a little modern twist, they've not gone, we need to make it all prosthetic because that looks more realistic.
Yeah.
They've gone, no, let's make these bulky plastic masks look like a real thing. And I love how they've gone for Doctor Who. Yeah, let's do that because it's what people want to see. And also, it just looks bloody great.
Oh, it's amazing. Yeah.
I don't think I've had this much joy in a returning monster since maybe the Zygons, or even before that. Like, I genuinely, I'm more excited about the Sea Devils coming back than Mundus and Cybermen or anything like that. That was,
I mean, like, come to think of it as well. Well, yeah, I guess, unless you count the Mundus and Cybermen, this is like the first proper moment for me, I guess, of where, you know, where something has returned that I've, like, a monster's return that I actually...
You knew about.
Exactly, I knew about. Like, you know, when the Silurians returned, I hadn't watched the Silurians or whatever. No. Or,
yeah, true.
And I think I was aware of the Ice Warriors. I might have had the action figure, I can't remember, something like that. Obviously, the Zygons as well, you know, you knew this was a monster from the past. This is, like, actually one that you've watched, and so it holds that much more weight, I think.
Mm.
On the design of it as well, one thing that stands out to me, which I can't really blame them for, but, like, if you remember, like, well, obviously the originals were the whole, basically the whole body, wasn't it, that was, like, in the costume for the skin. They've clearly thought this time, a bit like the Ood, you know, where it's just a mask, just the head, and then the rest of it is all clothes, like, very sneakily covering up the rest of the
body. Don't nitpick that, Richard. This is the Sea Devils coming back, nitpicking, for goodness sake. and you're nitpicking that they're not wearing Nessie.
Oh, no. I don't...
They're fashion sense.
Don't get me wrong. I do not want naked Sea Devils. No. I do not want that. But no.
I know what you mean. I know what you mean.
It makes a lot of sense. And hey, I mean, if that's how they're going to do it, and that's a way to do it in a way that is, you know, economic viable, exactly, then go for it.
I mean, look at that costume. I wouldn't be surprised if that's all reused materials and, you know, all that sort of stuff. Like, how good is that, actually, for a monster about the environment and things like that? The Sea Devils are perfect because they're reusing all these materials and things like that.
But that reminds me, I was reading a tweet this morning from Ray Holman.
I saw this about Aisling B's costume
materials and stuff.
Aisling B said she was really great. It was great that Ray Holman designed a totally 100% sustainable costume.
So actually, now you say that, I wouldn't be surprised if this was, like, literally stuff they'd gone.
Honestly, yeah,
gone to Cardiff Bay and, like, dragged some stuff out of the ocean.
Because you know that the costume that this Sea Devil was wearing. It sounds like I'm talking about, like, in Vogue magazine. Yeah. The costume that the Sea Devils decided to take on. The look that it's gone for, I wouldn't be surprised if this was a kind of... A bit like the Hemivores, you know, different outfits for each one of them. You know, it's just a hodgepodge of, you know, stuff they found in the ocean. Or, I think that works almost even better. Yeah. But regardless, you know, they just... Now, this is something I want an action figure of. This is something that I need to have as a toy. Only. You know... It's just, and I just can't get over the initial shock. I think that's the main.
I mean, to pick up on something there as well, just the cynical side of me sort of coming out here.
Don't even.
You mentioned how they might be wearing different outfits. Do you think there will be multiple Sea Devils? Because obviously we've only seen one.
Well,
you know?
It's Legend of the Sea Devils.
True,
is
I guess.
Legend of the Sea.
I think it's plural, actually. Yeah, yeah. So fair enough.
So there's
just a cynical side of me thinking, again, are they going to be economic and just have one? But
no, they won't do a Skaldak kind of Ice Warrior thing.
I hope not. But again, linked to that, are we going to get, like, another sort of iconic shot of them coming out of the ocean? But then I was thinking about that. Okay, no one saw that at filming. So does that mean they didn't do it?
Unless they did it CGI.
Secretly or CGI,
we've seen so much flux that indicates, like, that they can do, this, you know, without being spotted.
That'd be nice.
And also, just on that point of, you know, multiple Sea Devils.
Yeah.
We were talking, actually, one of my tweets that I just did of that we were filming a review was liked by Richard Price. Right? Yeah. He recently tweeted saying, "The Sea Devils are back, eh? Exciting stuff, wink, wink." Yeah. Ooh. So, that obviously means, reading between the lines, he's a Sea Devil.
Oh, now, do you mean he tweeted that since the reveal?
Yeah, he tweeted that since the reveal.
Oh, I thought beforehand. Yeah, okay.
He tweeted since the reveal, like a retweet of the trailer,
he'll
so great to finally reveal,
underneath,
I think he said.
The mask.
You know, finally reveal, this is it. So he plays monsters. If he's playing one, I'm not putting him down and saying, like, surely they wouldn't just get him to play it. But if he's playing one and he's played cohorts of monsters before, that indicates to me there's more than one Sea Devil.
Yes, and also, I guess...
That's me putting my Sherlock hat on there. And sort
They might have, like, one of them as a more well-known actor for the leader.
I think,
like,
Paul Casey is often the lead monster.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I think Paul Casey is still the...
Still mocking about,
I'm sure that he's always the prime...
Oh, like whatever. The Jadoon and things. And,
yeah, exactly. That rings about. So I'd say, you know, not putting Richard Price down.
Not at all, no.
But, like, no, I think that if he's one, if he's a Sea Devil, mm-hmm. then it's likely that there's a load of them.
Yes.
So that's my 2 cents. That's my scoop that I've, you know... We'll bring this back when we review Legend of the Sea Devils. When we'll bring this back.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
So I think there's going to be a big army of them. I wouldn't. I mean, given what we've seen them do with War of the Sontarans, are we going to get a big sea battle with pirates and Sea Devils? My God. I'm so excited for this episode. I don't think I've been this excited for an episode since. Yeah. I can't even think. Honestly, it's insane. But then also you've got to take on the fact this is Jodie's second to last story.
Yes, yeah, I know. And it's I mean, we sort of say in the other video, I don't know, are we expecting things to be ramped up in other ways perhaps? But then I don't know, I think it probably will be, well, fairly standalone. I don't know, you can never really know for sure. But like,
think about Waters of Mars in comparison to End of Time, you know, would you say that's kind of
Waters of the Sea Devils.
Waters of the Sea there we go. Wall Street. I mean, I suppose Waters of Mars is to some extent standalone as well. You know, it's not like every penultimate Doctor story has to be linked in.
That's true.
Yeah, so I that's interesting actually, because I was thinking that, but now saying it out loud, that's
I think as well, because I've sort of said elsewhere that, like, before we knew about this, you know, oh, Chinese pirates in, you know, penultimate story, okay. But, you know, I wonder if this is, like, this is part of a bigger globe-trotting thing. The minute they revealed the Sea Devils, I was like, okay, this is enough now.
Yeah,
you sold it to me, it's fine.
But it's funny, isn't it, how... Like, do you remember that prediction I made for Flux that, oh, we're going to get an episode of the Suffragettes and, you know, there's going to be one period, you know, Liverpool. Yeah. And obviously it was just a shot.
Yeah.
And then in this instance, I said after Flux, I was like, oh, yeah, it'll just be like a scene on a pirate ship, you know, Dan and the Doctor, and then it'll cut to something else.
Yeah.
No, this is the whole episode. From what we understand now.
Yeah.
Who knows?
I mean, I think it probably will be.
I can't see it not being anything
more. And I think, to be honest, that having two things, you know, first of all, the Sea Devils, obviously, and then in terms of your marketing as well, like a final last hurrah for the Chibnall historical, basically.
Yeah, true.
Another sort of Demons of the Punjab episode, are probably the only, like, white people in it are going to be the Doctor and Dan. So, like, it's going to be, you know, a whole other culture and stuff, isn't it?
How beautiful does it look? Have you seen, you know, all the pictures and they've stuff shared?
Yes.
Kudos to the designers and the DOPs,
absolutely.
You know.
Yeah.
It looks so nice. Like, who gave Doctor Who a Hollywood budget? Because they've done some fantastic stuff with what they've been given. It's incredible the work they've done on this episode, just from the look alone.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe how nice it looks. And you're right, how nice it is to have such a diverse cast for this episode. Do you know the historical figure? Have you heard of her before?
No. Not out.
Is she real? Is it real?
It's a real thing, I think. The thing the Doctor mentions as well, doesn't she, like a ship? At the end of Eve of the Daleks, like the treasure or wreckage of... We're going to go and find the wreckage of this ship.
She does, doesn't she? Yeah.
I googled that ship. I think it was from the 15th century or something, but this is meant to be later on, so I don't know whatever that is. It's very exciting, and as you say, you know, it's set within the context of, you know, like Marco Polo, Talons and Wang Chang, you know, it's good that
we're doing this let's hope, but we're doing it right, and that's great to see. The Sea Devils are coming back, Richard. The Sea Devils. It's insane. It's insane, and I'm very excited. For when do we think it will be? When roughly? Spring 2022. They've said.
I guess like Easter. Easter spring? That, but then
Easter is spring.
Yeah. I mean, this one's been on a Saturday, so I guess just despite everyone, they could say, like, for the final three episodes, we're gonna wear them all on Saturdays now,
I suppose they can't dictate when New Year's Day is, but you know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's a coincidence.
Maybe they'll just be like, yeah, let's settle on Saturdays. Yeah. I'd really like Doctor Who to be on Saturdays. So if they want to do that for Jodie's last episode, then please do, Chibs, because that'd be quite nice.
Crikey.
Yeah, I can't wait. I think it's just from a surface level kind of fan reaction, you know, the fanboy in me is...
Oh, exactly. That's what matters. Got it, so, yeah. Well, there we go.
There we go,
the
everyone.
Sea Devils are back.
Yeah. Cheers, mate. Yeah. Thank you.
Just unreal. Yeah. Absolutely unreal. After so many years.
He kept it under wraps for how long? You know?
Bonkers.
Yeah, insane.
Fantastic. Thank you. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Please like, please subscribe, please check out both our channels and all our back catalogue. And we will see you very shortly for our Eve of the Daleks review, which we've already recorded. And hopefully you'll enjoy that.
Or whether we'll be recording it again, we might be stuck in a time. Or whether we'll be recording it again, we might be stuck in a time. Or whether we'll be recording it again, we might be stuck in a time. Enjoy, everyone. Sea Devils! Woo!